Ladies and gentlemen, it is 12:20 p.m. on Wednesday, March 25th, 2020. I am Master Thich Thong Lai, and I would like to extend my warmest greetings to all of my fellow Buddhists and compatriots in the country as well as overseas. In the past few days in Seattle, Washington, the governor is ordering a 15-day isolation at home. No traveling without any essential needs. The area where I live has bad wireless connection. It is available sometimes and sometimes it is not. With that reason, I could not update the situation. However, at the request of some of my disciples from different places, they want to hear my voice to update the situation and news related to the situation of the Chinese virus, Chinese communists, Vietnamese communists, and the United States related issue. Therefore, I must have a talk this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, I spoke to my female disciple last night, who married in China and currently is in Hong Kong. She is waiting to go to the United States, but because she has not attained her visa. My disciple and her husband still have to wait for clearance. She talked to me to remind me to tell the people of Vietnam not to sell rice or grains. As you remember, during my talk 1 week ago, this disciple has sent a message that the Chinese communists instructed the Vietnamese communists to pay their tribute with food and medicine to rescue the Chinese communists. There is famine raving in Wuhan City, cities that are not like Wuhan, such as Shanghai, Xinhang, across the country, are also hungry and paralyzed. At the moment, she wants to send an important message to the Vietnamese people, especially the farmers. The Mekong River originates in Tibet, and this river has been controlled by the Chinese communists for decades. The Mekong River flows into the sea through the Vietnam Southern Delta. The Chinese communists built many dams to block the flow of the Mekong River. Cambodia is also affected, but they are not flooded with sea water because it is not possible to backflow from the South China Sea to flood Cambodia. The seawater is only flooded at 9 entries of Vietnam. After the Chinese communists built many dams, the Mekong Delta is now contaminated with salt water. China knows Vietnam will not have any rice to eat next year, so the Chinese communist buys more than 700 compared to other years. They buy more than 700% compared to other years. The puppet Nguyễn Song Phúc says the rice exporting has ceased to hide the truth. However, the Communist Minister of Industry and Trade continues to transfer goods to pay tribute to the Chinese communists. Last night, I spoke to my disco where the Chinese government gets the money to pay for the Vietnamese communists. She said the Vietnamese currents are printed by the Chinese communists. And even the money that the people of Wuhan threw on the streets is more than enough to pay. The Wuhan people died and threw their money on the streets. The Chinese government used that money to pay Vietnam. If that is not enough, they can always print more of Ho Chi Minh's currency. So it was a legal tribute. Once again, I sent a message to all fellow Buddhist followers in the Mekong Delta. Please keep your rice. Don't sell it. Because if you sell it now, when an epidemic breaks out, you will suffer from the famine. That is the campaign which the Chinese communists ordered the Vietnamese to tribute to all the necessities, especially rice. Let me tell you clearly, my female disciple said that because the Chinese army is hungry, the communist army is starving. No hunger army can fight. There are no convenient transport routes to China. From Cambodia, China will take a long time. Only the China-Vietnam railway is considered as the rapid transport. Vietnam transporting rice to China to pay tribute, and that is not the end yet. China will also make Vietnam submit a lot of other tributes. That's what my dispo told me last night. This female dispo has a Chinese husband, and her husband is working in the Xi Jinping government. They both are currently waiting for a visa to go to the United States, but are denied by President Trump's traveling restriction. No visa will be issued during this time. That's the first message. I now update the situation in the world. At midnight last night, the United States time, or yesterday afternoon in Vietnam, all Taiwanese Air Force has been rehearsed in an alarming state. They exercise in the red alert, while offshore in the East Sea area, Chinese communists are still in the 40-day exercise. Currently, the 7th Fleet Aircraft Carrier of the United States is present in the Eastern Sea as well. There are three in the Philippine Sea, four carriers south of the Sea of Japan and South Korea. Each carrier has six escorts, also known as cruisers, escorting them. We have seven U.S. aircraft carriers operating in the South China Sea and in the western parts of the Philippines, in the south and west of Taiwan Island, all of which are the aircraft carriers. And in 7th Fleet, and each aircraft carrier has six escorts, or total of 42 cruisers. Each cruiser are equipped with firepower that can demolish the Spratly Islands in a period of 4 hours. So the number of people infected in the United States is over 60,000. The number of deaths has reached 200. You know, the President of the United States, Donald Trump, is a presidential candidate to serve for the people of the United States, not to get paid. Obviously, he didn't accept the president's salary. And ever since he became president, his personal business have lost billions of dollars. You see clearly when the President of the United States give a speech, he gave for the love of his nation, not because for the sake of money. When he was not president, he was already a billionaire. And I repeat that when the number of American deaths total reaches 1,000, the Chinese better watch out for President Trump. He will not easily forgive. I want to remind you that 3 weeks ago, the Chinese communists used a laser from their warship to aim at U.S. aircraft in the Guatemala Island area. That was the first offense. Then recently, in the exercise area, the United States aircraft carrier present in the South China Sea, the U-shaped dash line. In a way, the United States directly declared war on Chinese communists. The United States had never started the war. You should remember that. During World War II, the United States did not start to fight until Japan attacked Hawaii in Pearl Harbor. Then the United States joined the Second World War. The United States always kept their integrity. I also want to make it clear, after stopping this corona outbreak and the United States returning to normal activities and the world returning to stability, the Chinese communists has no place to live in this world. Why is that? Let me tell you. For example, you live in a neighborhood in which there are many people, Cambodians, Laotian, French, Spanish, but if you create a virus called Wuhan and then you spread it to kill your neighbors, the number of people in that community will die in the hundreds and millions. After that, do people still let you be in that community? You can answer that question. The communist ship has no other way. The more the Chinese communist tries to blame the United States for the cause of the virus, the better the world can see the truth. The president of Italy cried while delivering a speech that he paid a very expensive price for this pandemic. When he learned about the virus, in turn with the United States, it appeared in Wuhan on November 7, 2019, but he trusted the director of the World Health Organization, WHO, so he didn't stop all the Chinese from doing business in Italy from traveling. Now, Italy has paid a great price. And the news I announced 4 weeks ago was also because of my female disciple said that the Chinese communists will operate a suicidal viral bomb mission. That was not only attacking the United States, but the whole world. Now the answer is obvious. I remember when I said that during my live stream, many people were sarcastic and thought there was no such thing. However, my female disciple kept insisting on me. She said, "Master, you must tell the people they can choose to believe or not. In 3 to 4 weeks, they will see." Now, the answer is clear. They have attacked the major cities of the United States. But don't worry. With the stimulus package of trillions of dollars that the President of the United States and the U.S. Department of Finance spend, I think that one day, not far from the United States, will stop the epidemic. And one important thing, this morning, VOA posted on their website about the aircraft carrier Roosevelt. While anchoring in Vietnam, a number of crews have come down to communicate with the Vietnamese Communist government sailors. Some of the aircraft carrier crews have visited a few places to perform entertainment to help the charity organization in Guangdong Province. Da Nang City. 15 days after leaving Da Nang Port, the Roosevelt carrier had a number of U.S. crew test positive for the Chinese virus. Currently, 5,000 sailors aboard the Roosevelt carrier aircraft carrier are in isolation for treatment. As you can see, the aircraft carrier anchored 7 nautical miles from the port of Da Nang Port for less than a week. The carrier was visible to the naked eye. A very limited number of crew members and advisor officers went to the port to shake hands with a number of Vietnamese naval forces. Now, they are infected after 15 days. Can you figure out what the number of infections in Vietnam is? An aircraft carrier with all healthy crew members after visiting Vietnam tested positive for the Chinese virus after 15 days. From that, you should have the answer for yourself. So this morning, some of my Buddhist followers, disciples in Na An, called and shared their worries. They had filmed clips of black crows coming from nowhere. They didn't know why the flocks of crows from the forest in the mountains were flooding the whole city they were in. They were very worried, and they asked me to tell a hexagram fortune to see if something will happen. What will happen to Nha An? I want to make it clear that you should not be superstitious. You should use the non-superstitious mind. When I asked many scientists in the United States why there are a swarm of black crows flying over the city of Wuhan during the pandemic when thousands and hundreds of people died, according to these scientists of the United States, the crows, because of the survival instincts, can smell the corpse 30 miles away. The birds resemble vultures. There are crows everywhere in the mountains. When the cremators begin to incinerate numerous dead corpses, the smell of death attracts hundreds of thousands of crows living in the forest 30 kilometers away. The crows have a very sharp sense of smell, so they gather at Wuhan City. Just like in South Korea, when the death toll reached tens of thousands, the crowd in the mountains of South Korea also are attracted by the smell of the corpse, and they gather there. Also in Italy, when the death toll of thousands increase every day, the smell of death scatter in the sky attract these crows that live in the mountains of Italy. Then they soar over the sky of Italy. And now the number of people who died in Vietnam, died because of suspected illness of a wound attack, died and were hidden by the police. That number of deaths have increased greatly. That is the reason the crows appear in Na An Province. These vultures have long lived in the jungle. They smell numerous corpses 30 miles away, so they fly out. It was a sign of death. Now I want to condemn a point. This morning, many Buddhist followers sent clips of a nightclub. This nightclub, named Buddha, And it has sexy music and exotic dancing. It has been operating for many years in the city of Ho Pirates, but no one pays attention. Videos of naked girls eating and dancing in front of the great Gomata Buddha statues have been shown, which is the cause of plague. I have shared these images this morning. There are cases of positive for the Chinese virus stemming from this disco club. The Chinese countess sabotaged Buddhist statues. They also destroyed churches and statues of the Virgin Mother. The Chinese countess destroyed religious belief and violate the divine. Now they were punished, and so was Vietnamese communists. Those who take the images of the Buddha to name the nightclub and have girls dressed exotically to vilify the Buddha will lose their guardianship and will be punished. And recently, many people have questioned why Mother Mushroom, who was sponsored by the U.S. President's wife to rescue her from the communist prison more than half a year ago, is so ungrateful. You should remember, I have given some talk that I am very cautious with prisoners of conscience. From the UK to all the prisoners for conscience present here because of our community campaign, the Vietnamese community has many campaigns, from national parliament to legislators to senators. We have clearly seen that the communists have infiltrated a lot of their members here. I do not mean all the prisoners of conscience. As a matter of fact, I still praise Drew Quoc Quyen. He has been loved and sponsored by our Vietnamese community to the United States. Drew Quoc Quyen still speaks day and night to defend the country and condemn the wrongs of the communist regime. Our prisoners of conscience, like Diu Cao, Tai Phong Tan, and Mother Mushroom, as you see, do not point fingers at all of them, but how many prisoners of conscience still have the anti-communist spirit like Trung Quốc Quy, and how many new prisoners came here to unveil their true identity? It will harm the prisoners of true conscience in the future. They are also those who really need the help from the Vietnamese community and need the help from the President of the United States and his wife. Without these help, the prisoners of conscience couldn't escape the communist labor camps. This is a big loss for many prisoners of conscience. Currently around 400 to 500. A person like Mother Mushroom or something doesn't mean anything. Because you see, ever since she arrived in America, I have never mentioned her name. But today, because of many people, that's why this woman is a senior politician. She decided to attack the President of the United States to benefit the communist regime during this period. I want to make it clear that at this stage, you don't need to listen to anyone else. The U.S. government is the free government. The President of the United States is elected by the people. This country has a National Assembly and legislative. The U.S. government made the number of infected cases public. The food scarcity stories are very just impulsive. If you go to Costco, you can see the supplies are overflowed. The Costco wholesale doesn't even accept all the sanitized supplies. There is no facial mask shortage like Wuhan. All the things Mother Mushroom did, just like our ancestors would teach. You can spend $30,000 to buy your credentials, but if you decide to throw it away, it's only worth 3 cents. You do not need to waste any more effort and time investigating her. We can assume that she has lifted her mask to reveal her true personality to declare who she really is. I have a lot of American friends. They told me that they realized the translation of the U.S. President Donald Trump's press conference by Mother Mushroom was deliberately mistranslated. I saw on the Facebook page of New T has the correct translation of the president's speech, so I just shared it. My fellow friends, we should never disrespect the Vietnamese community. There are 4 million Vietnamese living abroad with 8 million eyes. They have 4 million hearts, and they have 4 million bright minds. And that there are many minds with a high level of scientific technique and scientific qualifications. We cannot underestimate them, and we think that we are wiser than the 4 million overseas. We cannot think that these compatriots are foolish. That is all I want to say. The Vietnamese Communists, you should not think that your 4 million party members are smart and the 95 million people are foolish. Don't ever think that you are smarter than the people. The people are forever, but the party is only temporary. In summary, war at the Eastern Seas can happen anytime. Last night, I was talking to my female Buddhist follower who has her husband working in the Chinese Communist government. The Chinese Communists will choose the following location at their battlefield. The first battlefield is Vietnam. The second battlefield is the Eastern Sea or Philippines. They choose the Philippines because Philippines have cut off all treaties with the United States to protect them. The Chinese Communists and the Philippines have disputed islands such as the Scarlet Islands. The Chinese Communists can use the Scarlet Islands as an excuse to attack the Philippines. When there is a battle, the Chinese armies that were about to rebel will change their mind and stand with Xi Jinping. The Chinese Communists would then ease the discontent that happened in the army and the famine that they had to deal with. The United States does not have a single treaty agreement to protect the Philippines. However, the U.S. will protect the East Sea via the Freedom of Navigation Treaty because this is an important area for transferring goods of the U.S. and its allies. The United States does not have a treaty with Vietnamese Communists either. They have been holding hands with the Chinese Communists at day and night. And they went out with the United States. The United States does not want to play that game anymore. The American consulate were closed, and the United States have called on their citizens to leave Vietnam as soon as possible. Meanwhile, all U.S. consuls in countries with pandemic areas, even in China, have not closed. But why close in Vietnam? Look at that to know that a war is about to happen. And why the seventh flotilla of the United States, four were in the South China Sea, three in the Philippine Sea, total seven aircraft carriers and 42 escorted cruisers were in the South China Sea. War might happen, although President Trump doesn't want the war now, because the number of Americans continue to die, and with hatred, the situation can be changed. Yesterday, Taiwan conducted its own military exercise at 12 p.m. Vietnamese time, while China is still practicing its 40th day military exercise, and the United States is still in the South China Sea. So the war will happen in the South China Sea. The Chinese Communist doesn't have any other way. There is only one option with four battlefields to choose. If China decides to fight, a battlefield war will occur in China, which is the Civil War. The second battlefield is Taiwan. Taiwan has been long threatened by China. President Tsai Ing-wen is already prepared for defense. Taiwan's Air Force is also very strong. She has 67,000 missiles aimed at the Chinese Communists. The third battlefield is Vietnam. The Chinese don't need to fight Vietnam anymore, really. Nguyễn Phú Trọng is just a scarecrow, whether he lives or dies. No longer matters. Nguyễn Xuân Phúc sometimes made false statements, and now the Vietnamese government is run by Chinese Communists, so it is not important to fight Vietnam. Finally, the Chinese Communists will choose the Eastern Sea. Battlefield in Eastern Sea is fighting with the United States and against the Philippines. Although the Philippines no longer have a treaty with the United States, but when the communist ships attack on the Scarlet Island of the Philippines, the Philippines still has a seat as a nation of the United Nations. It has been an independent country since World War II. If the Chinese communists attack, the United States still has an excuse to fight against the Chinese Communists navies. Whether the battlefield would take place in the South China Sea, in Taiwan, in Vietnam, or in China, is the decision of the Chinese Communist leadership. At present, Xi Jinping no longer controls the Shanghai Military Region, the Xinhing Military District, and the Hubei Military District. Jiang Zemin has power in the Chinese Communist regime, and the military is hungry and dies. They have nothing to fear to die. 14 million to 20 million phones stops their service is not normal. It is not just phones using wireless service, but the phone companies say that out of the 14 million, there are 7 million landline phones. A landline phone is a telephone placed at home. The subscribers stop paying their bills. There was also no answer, and no one knows why 7 million landline phones and 14 million cell phones stop operating. So the death toll in China is expected to range from 7 million to 14 million. This number compared to the population of 1.4 billion is very small. The Chinese government can sacrifice 400 million people to die so they can dominate the world. Unfortunately, the dream of the Chinese communists no longer exists. A Belt, a Road program. Is a failure. The President of the United States activated the trade war to show the world the true face of Chinese communists. And now the whole world sees it clearly. Once this epidemic is over, the Chinese communists would lose and collapse. If the Chinese communists decide to go without war, they still die. Either way, the Chinese Communist Party will be over. There will be no companies that will spend money on investigating in Chinese communists as before the outbreak of Wuhan on January 23, 2020. So every path would lead to termination. Therefore, Xi Jinping would choose a war to preserve the Communist Party by fighting against the Vietnamese in the South China Sea. Shooting at the United States in the South China Sea or having a war with Vietnam so that the United States would send troops to intervene. That would be the excuse to surrender. Fighting Vietnam will be hard for the United States to intervene because the Communists had not signed any treaty to protect Vietnam. Therefore, the Philippines is a better bet. President Trump is crazy right now. I said when the death toll of American reaches 1,000, you will see his response. With the love for the people and his determined personality, he will do what he needs to be done if the Chinese provoke anger in the United States. Because the United States cannot sit still to watch the Chinese communists continue the suicide bomb mission attacking the United States. And Chinese communists also knows they're only fighting with the United States so they can surrender. When their economy is still prosperous, they didn't dare to fight. Why go to war at this moment? What is their purpose of starting war? They want to fight so they can lose, because if they lose, they can sign the surrender agreement. The United States will not kill Xi Jinping, just like the United States fought Japan during World War II. The United States did not hang the Japanese emperor. They allowed the emperor to keep his throne. Xi Jinping hoped that he would be able to keep his regime if China fight with the United States. The United States will win and China will be defeated. The Chinese communists will surrender. Upon surrendering, the United States will preserve Xi Jinping's life. I think that just the United States alone is enough to win the Chinese communists. But at that time, England will get involved. France and Italy will not simply forgive the Chinese communists. As you can remember, the eight countries coalition in the Qing dynasty also tore up China for 100 years. At this time, the eight countries coalition led by the United States would also tear apart the Chinese communists in the near future. Once again, the people in the country, please do not sell rice. Do not sell any food that can be stored for a long time, because my female disciple said the Chinese communists ordered the Vietnamese communists to pay tribute to everything available in Vietnam. The Chinese communists are starving and cannot allow the Vietnamese people to be full. So people must protect themselves. Do not believe what the communists said, but look closely at what the communists are doing. Sincerely, respect and strive to protect your survival until the day this epidemic is ended by the free countries in the world.
Liên bưng quân Bắc Quốc thời kỳ nhà Thanh cũng đã xé nát nước Tàu 100 năm. Và kỳ này liên quân Bắc Quốc do Hoa Kỳ lãnh đạo cũng sẽ xé nát Tàu Cộng một ngày không xa. Một lần nữa, đồng bào trong nước không bán gạo, không bán những cái lương thực nào có thể dự trữ để lâu. Vì người nữ đệ tử của tôi nói rằng Tàu Cộng sẽ ra lệnh cho Việt Cộng phải triều cống tất cả những cái gì mà Việt Nam đang có. Tàu Cộng đang đói, không thể nào Tàu Cộng để Việt Nam no được. Cho nên người dân phải tự bảo vệ mình. Đừng tin vào những gì Cộng sản nói, mà hãy nhìn kỹ những gì Cộng sản đang làm. Trân trọng kính chào và ráng bảo vệ sống còn cho tới ngày trận dịch này được thế giới tự do coi như tiêu diệt.